Let's go! Big things are happening right now. I got a couple of charts to show you right now, which all are indicating a big move for Bitcoin very soon. So guys, you want to stick around if you're holding Bitcoin, Ethereum, or any other altcoin. Thank you so much for getting back to the channel. My name is Cristiano, bringing you cryptocurrency videos every day, teaching you how to make money in this market. If you are new to this channel, then make sure to subscribe and activate the bell right now. Okay, let's get straight into Bitcoin here first. And the first thing I want to say is that you can see that we are clearly above my orange box here at 34,200. And you can see that we got supported multiple times here. So we went above it, but we actually got supported here on the wicks and almost at the bottoms of the candles. But nonetheless, I mean, we found some support in this vicinity. And since this level, since shooting up here, we've actually now made a push towards the $36,000, which of course is the big cluster of resistance. So this is not going to be easy to break through, guys. So what I want to say now is there's a couple of things. First off, if you were buying down here at $30,000, as you know, I took profit as we're approaching this blue line here. So that's me as a short-term trade. If you bought for your long-term holdings, well, that's completely different, of course. But as a trade and for the situation right now, I think it's going to take a lot to break through the blue line here, because you also have, again, the cluster of resistance. Actually, what you can see is that we went all the way up here. We got rejected right off of the 200 period moving average on the 4-hourly time frame. So you can see the wick reaching the purple line right here before going down. So, I mean, the momentum in Bitcoin is clearly bullish right now. It's clearly bullish. But until we are above the blue line here and all of these moving averages, actually, I would say until we are above the $42,000 level, we are not out of the woods yet. So I would urge everyone to be cautious right now. But long term, of course, Bitcoin is going to continue to go up. But if you're looking at this as a trade, I do need to give you that heads up that we do have significant resistance here at $36,000. So what else is there? Well, there's a couple of things. First off, the W pattern, you can see that the neckline is actually right here. And we are right now struggling with the neckline. But maybe we are going to break through this. And of course, the technical target from this W pattern here, which you're seeing, is actually all the way up here. So into the box at $40,000. So that's looking good. So that's bullish for Bitcoin. So let's continue, because this is not all. As I said, there's going to take a lot of momentum to break through the cluster of resistance here. But maybe we're able to get that momentum off of this big, massive descending wedge. So this pattern is actually on the daily time frame, and this goes all the way back to the 8th of May. Now, you have clearly a lot of touching points on the lower end here. So let me show you. So you got a couple of touching points here. I cannot even count these, but it's very clear. And on the upper end, you have a couple of touching points off of this actual candle right now. You have three touching points off of this range here. And you have a couple of touching points here at the top of the wedge as well. So this is a bullish pattern. And I mean, we could, from a technical standpoint, you know, technically go all the way up here just based on this big wedge here. So we will see about that, but a lot of people are probably watching this and they are ready to put in their long orders as soon as we're breaking this level. So this combined with what we are also seeing on the W pattern right here. Oh, actually it's on the 4-hourly time frame. So the W pattern right here, you got the wedge, both of these perhaps when you see that breakout, because we are right there, guys. We're right on the edge of the W pattern. We're right at the edge of the massive wedge here as well. This one here on the daily time frame. So yeah, definitely this is looking good. We will see. We will see, guys, if we do get enough momentum to break this to the upside. But that's not all. I want to show you something else. If we go to this chart, you know, on the 4-hourly time frame where I overlaid the wickoff pattern. Well, I did tell you yesterday that according to the wickoff pattern, if this is going to play out the same and follow this pattern, well, that would mean that we need to go sideways for a little bit and down for a little bit before having another big pump to the upside. So if you're watching this right now, I mean, if we just zoom out here to get you an overview, you can see how it's been following the wick of pattern right here on the 4-hourly time frame. Although some people say that you cannot apply the wick of pattern on the 4-hourly time frame, I would say that this is following it pretty damn well. So for now, this is how it's looking. And maybe we are now going to, since we are going sideways, we did go down a little bit here, maybe we are going to have that big pump. And perhaps this is also going to take us all the way up to $43,000, which is, of course, as you remember, right into the vicinity right here at my orange box and the red line. So everything is lining up now very, very nicely, guys, I have to say. Now, is this all just a big, massive bull trap? Are the whales just manipulating us, trying to get us to be bullish, printing all of these patterns like the wedge here? Maybe they are, but you know, there's no denying it. And even if we continue to go down, even if we crash down here, it's just going to be an even better buying opportunity. But from a technical standpoint, things are looking good right now. And I'm going to go with my TA. It's been working good so far. We did buy here multiple times at $30,000. And here's the thing. Even if we do crash down here, we've been making so many trades here, riding it from the downside or riding it from the $30,000 to the upside, taking massive profit as we're getting into this vicinity. So I wouldn't even mind a crash down here. It's just an even better buying opportunity, and we've still been making massive gains here. So that kind of equalizes things out. But there's another thing I want to show you, and stick around because this is very important. But first, before I talk about this massive, important pattern, if you're enjoying this content so far, then make sure to subscribe and activate the bell. And also leave a like if you're liking this video. Now, I want to show you this. So this is the Pule multiple. And what is the Pule multiple? And you can see it down. Actually, let me make this a little bit larger. So I'm going to make the RSI a little bit smaller. So, right, something like that. You got the Bitcoin price up here and you got the Pule multiple down here. And what I want to show you, first off, again, what is the Pule multiple? Well, the Pule multiple can be interpreted as if all mined Bitcoins were sold immediately in the market, how profitable mining pools are compared to the last historical 1 year. So you compare all of the Bitcoin mined right now, how profitable are the miners compared to the last year? So this metric helps traders gauge the market cycles from the global view. And this is interesting because look at this. So what we can see is that you clearly have a couple of bottoms here in the Pule multiple, again, defining how profitable the miners are. So this is actually on-chain data, or economic data more than, you know, candle bars and patterns. But what you can see is that we did see a bottom here on the Pule multiple, right here, the green arrow, and that actually coincided with the Bitcoin price going down. And by the way, guys, the Bitcoin price being aligned with the mining, the profitability of miners is actually going to make sense when you think about it, because as the Bitcoin price is going down, also the mining profitability goes down. So, I mean, they're going to follow each other a little bit, but not entirely, because what you can see also is that, we had this low here on the Pule multiple at the low here in 2011. We had a second low right here close to the support line, but the price was a little bit higher here. But this gave us two very important signals because these two actually defined the bottom in Bitcoin. And let's continue. So we had a couple of other touching points here on the support line. You had one right here. This coincided with Bitcoin reaching $183 here in 2014. And you had a second touching point here as well. So both of these defined the bottom for the bull or the bottom for the bear market. And since then we went up, just like since here we also went up. Let's continue. In 2018, Bitcoin miners became unprofitable, or we got into this support level again. So this green line right here, this also defined the bottom. If you bought off of this support line, you made a lot of profit. You buy here, price goes up. Now let's look at 2020, and you can see here we didn't get right into it here on the yellow arrow, but definitely on the green arrow we got very at least very close to the support line, if not even touching it. And again, this was the COVID crash. Very good buying opportunity here, the orange arrow. And of course, the green arrow was at about $7,500. And I remember the FUD here. People were saying, like, we're going to get into this death spiral because miners are going to be so unprofitable. They're going to sell everything. Bitcoin is going to crash to zero. But look at this. You buy here, you go up. And look at this. We are right now also at support. Now, maybe this is a bit of a black swan event because miners are moving out of China. So maybe we should not put too much into it. But on this data, on this chart, you can very clearly see that we are getting to the same support level. And this has been a good buying opportunity pretty much always. So I am going to keep you updated on this, guys. Also, you're having these patterns on the RSI. You're having these downward sloping channels, and you're also having it right here. So looking good. Looking good, guys. Finally, I want to talk a bit about... Actually, let me save Ethereum for the next video. So if you want to watch some Ethereum content, make sure to subscribe and activate the bell. Activate the bell so that you get notified as soon as I release that video talking about Ethereum. It's going to come later today. So I will see you right there at that video. But thank you so much for watching this one, and I will see you in the next one.